Hi friends, very good morning. Today the weather at Hyderabad is so chilling. Oh my god, it's 12 to 13 degrees temperature. Fine. So it's been exactly from today 30 days you have for the exams of January 2021. So now the question for some of the students, especially those who decided to write both the groups in the January cycle, means they have opted out in the November 1st cycle and both the groups they are writing, they decided to write in the second cycle, January exams. Now the confusion started. Sir, should I write single group or should I write both the groups? Which one to be decided for January 2021 exams? I have the answer for you. Just simple tiebreaker rule, we will apply and decide. Again, no more queries on this. If at all you are having any doubts, you can contact me, but don't put so much of argument on this. Based on some logical evaluation, I decided this. Should you write single group or you have to write both the groups? Whether you're a final student or inter student, doesn't matter, the logic is same. Yes, what is the decision criteria? I finally arrived five combinations. I finally arrived five conclusions. What are my five conclusions? Suppose you see the headings. You have to decide it today, 22nd December. So suppose one group means not group one, okay? First understand, it may be group one or group two. Other group means other group, okay? So one group, you completed fully one of the group. And other group, you completed at least 50% of the each subject. You completed at least 50% of each subject. Only half left. In such a case, what you can do, 20 days you have, 5 days each, allocate to each subject, you can finish the remaining at least 30% syllabus, 80% of the syllabus you can finish in other group. Suppose assume you completed group 1 completely. In group 2, almost in every subject, you are very much confident of more than 50% of the syllabus at least. Then another 30% of the syllabus you add it to your schedule, stick on to the next 20 days for that particular 30% syllabus, finish it. Again, last 10 days, revise the first group, then go and write the exam. Write the second group. So write both the groups. Suppose in one of the group you cover 2/3 of the syllabus. In other group also you cover 2/3. In both the groups together 1/3 only left. You can also write both the groups. Why? Because you are also having 30 days time. 30 days time. Out of 30 days, if you properly plan it, you can easily write both the groups. 30 days time means even if I take 5 days holidays, since you are writing both the groups, let us have 12-hour schedule. You are having 300 hours. 300 hours is not an ordinary time. Okay, fine. I'll come to that later. Third combination. You completed one of the group. But in the other group, you completed one subject properly. Suppose at CA Inter, this is how generally people prepare. They complete first group preparation. And in second group, they'll be very confident of advanced accounts. Some will be confident of FM and economics. Remaining three subjects, preparation would have been very, very light or moderate. Less than 50%, not even 50% covered. Then what you can do, you know, write both only. But single group, whatever you prepared perfectly, you know, that you have to qualify for sure. That is the ultimate agenda. Plus, that one subject in the other group, which you are completely confident of, try for scoring exemption. Remaining three subjects, don't touch. Less than 50%. Why to start fresh preparation today again? Don't study. You stick to one group, finish it off, and also the one subject in the other group, try to score exemption. So whatever the available 25-30 days time that you have, sharpen it. Next, in one of the group, you did not cover 2/3 of syllabus also. Other group also, you did not cover 2/3 syllabus also. In both the groups, 50-50% only you covered syllabus. If you still stand today onwards on the both the groups, you will fut both the groups. So no, assess whether group 1 or group 2, which one is having higher weightage in your mind, which one you think you can easily can crack, assess that and fix for single group of your choice, whichever you feel convenient, whichever you feel very confident of. Again, in this, don't bring confusion. Sir, I don't know, I myself unable to decide group 1 or group 2, I'm unable to decide what to do. That and all, I can have an answer. Okay, I'm giving you this kind of analysis itself is, took lot of time for me to think and put it in the easiest way for you to understand. And finally, one of the group, two-thirds syllabus you completed, two-thirds you completed. Whereas another group you have not started or partially started, some 20-30% of the syllabus only you did. Then shed the other group. That group which you completed two-thirds of the syllabus, no, you still have 25 days time. Finish remaining one-third. Finish, stick to single group. So these are the possible combinations which I can actually arrive. If at all you are having another combination, you are having a doubt, you can just put it in the comment section or you can just message me. Okay, I'll give my contact details later. I hope until now every one of you are clear. If not, watch again. And finally, I wanted to remind you the exam schedule. The exam schedule for CA Foundation is 21st January. And final group 1, 21st January. Final group 2, 30th January. Intergroup 1, 22nd January. And intergroup 2, 1st January. And allotment of time. If at all you are wanting to write both the groups, you don't have option. Out of 30 days, from today to Jan 20th, 30 days you have. Out of 30 days, 5 days even if you take up holidays, every day you have to study for 12 hours, 300 hours. One of the group, you give 160-70 hours. For other group, give time for revising for 130 hours. Because generally, suppose you take CA final, group 1 takes higher amount of time for preparation compared to group 2. For some students, group 2 may take higher time. So you weight yourself and accordingly allocate the time, 300 hours. If you are writing single group, no need to worry about the allocation of time. 25 days multiplied by 10, 250 hours, a solid time even if you start fresh preparation in order to complete at least two-thirds of the syllabus. But I think by this time, those who are watching this video, you would have already completed some percentage of syllabus. So need not worry. And second group students, don't even think of negative feeling, okay? Don't even think of it. You are having 35 days here, 40 days actually, but okay. Even if I take off 5 days for holidays, 35 days, at least if you prepare 8 hours a day, you are getting 280 hours. Again, if you think of, will I qualify second group? I already failed so many times. You fail so many times because you are not having 100% conceptual clarity. What is meant by conceptual clarity? What is meant by presentation? What is meant by how to score higher marks in various subjects? In the same channel, whatever, wherever you are watching the video, you have those videos also. You can just watch them in your free time. Don't lose hope. Feel confident. And finally, suppose some of you are willing to take fast track revision classes at this moment. Don't worry, we have recordings for accounting standards, taxation, auditing, AS and SM, and economics for finance. We have recordings. And if at all you want to have recording or you want to have a word with me, you have any other doubts or queries, this is how you can reach us. So you can call me 9700273087. I am Ram Harsha. Okay, and my mail ID is there. We have given our mail ID. Telegram group is also there where we can clarify so many doubts and queries similar to this. We have a YouTube channel. Of course, you're watching this video in the channel and Instagram account. That's it. So I hope you are now a little bit clear, little more, you got some clarity. Fine. That's it. All the best. Bye-bye.